This is the 25th anniversary experience.
It's been one quarter of one century since two unknown South Park, Colorado boys started a phenom.
I think it's the fact that they're not afraid to poke fun at everything. And people need to laugh. That's one thing that's pervasive for 25 years. It's never going to go away.
The irreverent South Park cartoon, then movies, then music, and now even food. There's a lot to celebrate. That's why Red Rocks Park was chosen as a location for South Park 25, the musical performance.
When you hear it on the show, it's a little bit like children's sing-songy, but when you hear it in practice here, it's professional bands, professional musicians, and you really start to realize how actually incredibly complex these songs are and how great they sound when done live.
For South Park fans, this container is the holy grail.
All the things that is part of the show's universe, original storyboards and scripts, toys and collectibles that are a huge part of the show's history.
The first concert was on Tuesday night. Every single South Park song was performed live by Matt and Trey to a sold-out crowd. Tonight, the second and last show.
They're composers. They're people who think about songs in the complex way that songs need to be. It's not just an actual sort of cartoon. There's actually like a lot of skill. They're skilled musicians.
South Park 25, an irreverent journey into the creative brains of a couple South Park boys. Daru, Fox 31.